Hello everyone. Now we are going to discuss hybridization. Hybridization. Why we come from for a hybridization topic? Actually, yesterday we discussed that carbon can able to form four bonds. In that four bonds, one s orbital, okay, 2s, and 2px. 2py, 2pz. The four different orbitals with a different energy, they are participating in bond formation. In case of methane, CH4, bond angle is 109 degrees. 28 minutes. Actually, the four orbitals are with different shape and different energy. So, the bond angle should be different. But here, it is proved that bond angle in methane is 109 degrees 28 minutes only. That means, this bond formation was unable to explain with a simple covalent bond. Okay, to that we are going to discuss hybridization. The hybridization, the concept of hybridization is successfully explained about the bond angles. This is given by Linus Pauling. In 1931, in the year of 1931, he has given the theory of concept of hybridization, right? So, what is hybridization? What is hybridization, sir? See here, hybridization means the redistribution of orbitals of almost equal energy in individual atoms to give equal number of new orbitals with identical properties like energy and shape is called as hybridization. Is called hybridization. Now I will explain. Wait. Okay. We discussed the carbon atoms atomic number is 6. In the ground state, its electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. In excited state, its electronic configuration 1s2, 2s1, 2p3. That means your 2px and 2py and 2pz. 2px, 2py, 2pz. Right? See here. Then when okay, we discussed that. Actually, s orbital consists of two electrons in its ground state. But in excited state, the electron from 2s orbital is jumps to 2pz. One electron is jumps from 2s orbital. Here it has two electrons, no? Then from out of these two electrons, one electron can jumps from 2s orbital to 2pz orbital when it is in excited state. Then it becomes, its electronic configuration becomes like this. So finally, it having the four unpaired electrons. Yesterday we discussed promotion of electron can be takes place in this way. Right? Here this is s orbital. This is px, this is py, and this is Pz. Okay, Px, Py, Pz. Right. Then here, these two, this s orbital, p orbitals are belonging to the same atom, but they have little bit different in energy levels. Okay, s orbital and p orbital. If we comparing these two, p orbital and s orbital, right? P orbital having little bit higher in energy, right? Here the hybridization is takes place in s orbital and px, py and pz orbitals. Here what he said, the redistribution of orbitals of almost equal energy in individual atom to give equal number of new orbitals with identical properties like energy is called energy and shape. That means, first of all, these two, these three, these four can intermix. Okay, with the different energies, no, S, Px, Py, Pz, with these different energy orbitals or remix and mix, and they redistributed into the equal number of orbitals, then how many orbitals are participate in hybridization? 4, s orbital, px orbital, py orbital, pz orbital. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. How many orbitals? 4 orbitals are participate in hybridization, right? That means after intermixing these 4 orbitals, how many orbitals can be redistributed? 4. What are they? Then like this. Good data. Then see, how many intermixed? 1, 2, 3, 4. Then how many we got? 1, 2, 3, 4. And here, the redistributed orbitals are having the equal energy, right? Here, see here, this given figure is represents that. Then this is little bit lower in energy. This is little bit higher in energy. After redistribution, the hybrids, these are called as hybrids. Hybrids are having the same energy. Okay, right. And here, then we have to give the name. What kind of hybridization, sir? It is what kind of hybridization, sir? Here it is. Then how many 4 orbitals or intermixed? No. One is s orbital, 3 p orbitals. That means we have to give the name sp3. Got it? This is called as hybridization. Okay, hybridization means very simple. Then after intermixing of almost equal energy levels orbitals can remix, and they redistributed into the equal number of orbitals like this hybridized. See here, S, Px, Py, Pz, these 4 are intermixed and they redistributed with the same shape and the same energy levels. Right, I will show you one thing. Here, actually S orbital spherical in shape. Okay, s orbital spherical in shape, px orbital, and here py and pz. Okay, what happened here? S orbital, px orbital, py orbital, pz orbital, these 4 orbitals are intermixed, and they have this. See, these 4 or s orbital and p orbitals are different in shape or not? We have already discussed in structure of atom. S orbital is in spherical in shape, p orbitals are dumbbell in shape, right? After the intermixing, they can get a equal number and equal energy. And here, he has given same shape also, same energy. Here see, all are in same line. Then it proves that this figure proves that same energy. Right, sir, what's about shapes, sir? Then how many four we will get now? Like this. Right. Got it? See, S orbital in spherical in shape, dumbbell in shape, but after remixing, after redistribution, these four are having the same shape or not, similar shape or not. Okay, this is, they all the four are in the similar in shape and similar in energy. This is called as hybridization. This is called as hybridization. Okay, then this hybridization is takes place in case of methane. In case of methane, so how bond formation is takes place, sir? That we are going to discuss now. Right? Okay. The methane carbon atom. Okay, atomic number is 6. Like that. Then hydrogen atom. Atomic number is 1. That means it has only s orbital, 1s orbital, 1s orbital. The hybridization is takes places, the bond formation is takes places like this. Okay. Okay. This is one sp3, this is one sp3, this is one sp3, this is one sp3. Okay, right? These are bonded with 4 sp3. Okay, 4 lone pair electrons are going to bond formation with 4 hydrogen atoms. This is one hydrogen atom. This orbital is s, and here one hydrogen atom, s orbital. Here it is one s orbital. Here it is one s orbital. Okay. Then how many bonds it formed? 4 bonds. Right. See here, sp3s, sp3s. Here sp3s. Here sp3s. Got it? Right? Here all are same orbitals only, no? sp3 s orbital, sp3 s orbital, sp3 s orbital, sp3 s orbital. Then same in shape and same in energy, equal in shape and equal in energy. So that's why their bond angle also should be equal or not, should be equal or not. So that's why its bond angle is 109 degrees, 109 degrees, 28 minutes. It was successfully explained. Okay, right, got it. This kind of bond formation is takes place in case of methane. That means your carbon atom can able to form sp3 hybridization also. It can able to form sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization means, in sp3 hybridization, 1 s orbital, 3 p orbitals will be participating. Okay, right. Then now, sir, carbon atom can able to form only sp3 hybridization, or it can able to form, right, other hybridizations also. Now we are going to discuss here. So right, here in case of now here we are going to discuss in case of ethylene or ethene. In case of ethene, okay, right. Here in this case, here C2H4, its formula is C2H4. Okay, now we are going to discuss. Here, in this year, ethene, then sp2 hybridization will take place. What hybridization? sp2, Hauser. Then see, in excited state, s orbital and right, here s orbital and px and py and pz. Here in case of sp3 hybridization, s orbital and px orbital and py orbital. Got it? Here s orbital, px orbital and py orbitals can forms hybridization. Okay, then here only out of the 4 different orbitals, only 3 orbitals are participating in hybridization. The pz is individually. That means after intermixing, then we get a like this. How many orbitals they participated? 1, 2, 3. Then how many hybrids we get? 3 only. 1, 2, 3. Why? Because 3 it participated. Then what is the name of that hybridization? sp2. Why we have given sp2 hybridization? Why? Because here one s orbital, 2 p orbitals are participated. One s orbital and 2 p orbitals. That means here sp2. Got it? So right. Then its shape. See, spherical. Then I will show the shape. Right? Spherical in shape. Right? Like this. So after intermixing, we get in the same shape, no? Like this. See? This is in different shape. Different in shape, different in shape. Here, finally we got 3 in the same shape. And what's about PX, sir? Sorry, what's about PZ, sir? PZ is not participated in hybridization, no? Then that means it is individually like this. Okay? These 3 are in equal in energy. Right? These 3 sp2 orbitals energy is equal. If comparing with this pz, okay, these 3 are having the equal, but we compare sp2 hybrid and pz orbital is different. Okay, is this is a way. What is its shape? See here. See, its shape also different, no? This is a way. So this is called sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization means the hybridization can be takes place between one s orbital and 2 p orbitals. One s orbital and 2 p orbitals, and they gives 3 like energy and like in shape. Okay, right. In case of ethane, so 3 hybrids. Now we are going to draw that. Then carbon atoms. Okay? Alright. See here. This is one sp. This is one sp. And this is one sp2. Sorry. sp not. sp2. 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 Right? Okay? Then one more is there. No. That is what? Pz. Pz, right. Here, this is Pz. This is Pz. Like in case of other carbon atom also, one more, okay. ओके दिस इज sp2 ओके राइट हियर दिस इज वन pz एन अदर कार्बन आटम राइट ओके सी हियर वन कार्बन आटम हाउ मेनी बॉन्ड्स इट कैन एबल टू फॉर्म फोर बॉन्ड्स राइट सी हियर ओके देन हियर हाउ मेनी हाइड्रोजन आटम्स फोर हाइड्रोजन आटम्स राइट देन इन केस ऑफ सी हियर वन हाइड्रोजन आटम with s orbital here one more hydrogen atom with s orbital and here one hydrogen atom s orbital and s orbital got it then hydrogen here sp2 s orbital okay got it then one carbon can able to form four bonds no yesterday we discussed in our last class we discussed right okay then here still two bonds in out of the two bonds one bond formation can be takes place between sp2 and sp2 okay sp2 see like this sp2 what's about this bond formation sir then in between px pz and pz this is the bond formation this is the structure of a ethane molecule c2h4 got it so here see here how many bonds are formed 1 2 okay 3 4 5 6 how many bonds 6 bonds total 6 bonds right here we knows that here end on end okay here also end on end here end on end okay that means this is called a sigma bond 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 here also sigma bond right then what's about the bond formation between pz that is partially so that's why that is called as pi bond then out of the 6 bonds here 5 sigma bonds how many 5 sigma bonds and a one pi bond okay 5 sigma bonds and one pi bond is takes place in case of ethane then because of that's why its bond angle becomes 120 degrees its bond angle is 120 degrees right here you have to know in case of methane okay in CH4 how many bonds only 4 bonds right got it only 4 bonds that 4 bonds also sigma bonds only out of 4 then 4 out of 4 sigma bonds here 6 bonds but the out of the 6 bonds 5 sigma bonds and one pi bond is takes place right sir here then from this we came to know that here it can able to takes place then sp3 hybridization and sp2 hybridization right here we have discussed sp2 hybridization now we are going to discuss in case of C2H2 what kind of hybridization is going to takes place okay and here you have to notice one thing in case of CH4 four bonds also single bonds here one double bond. Got it? Here one double bond, remaining all single bonds. Right? Now here we are going to discuss one more topic. Okay. Right. Here are C2H2. In case of C2H2. See here, this one electron in s orbitals and remaining three. 1, 2, 3. Px, Py, Pz. In case of C2H2, in case of C2H2, here sp hybridization can takes place. That means here only one s orbital, one p orbital. Okay, one s orbital, one p orbital can participate in case of hybridization. So Py and Pz are free from hybridization. Here in sp hybridization in this C2H2 case, then s orbital, px orbitals are participating in hybridization. So how many orbitals are participates in hybridization? Only two. That means we will get two like orbitals, right? Okay, then shape. See here, in case of spherical, right? Okay, out of these two only intermixing, these are as it is. So these two are intermixing now, then we will get same shape or not, right? Like this. Okay, then same shape. And what's about Py and Pz? Py and Pz are free from hybridization. No, then there are different Py as Py and Pz or Pz. What's about these are sp orbital, sp orbital. Why we have given sp and sp? Why? Because only one s orbital, one p orbital are participated in the hybridization. So because of this sp and sp, okay, right? Py and pz are individual, and their shapes like this only, right? Now here the bond formation, here the bond formation can takes place like this. Okay, see, this is one orbital, this is one sp, this is one sp of a given orbital. And okay, this is one sp, this is one sp, right? Okay, right. And next, here it has Py. This also having Py. Okay. And Pz. Then practice the diagram how to draw these bond formations. Okay, P, Y, right? Here C2H2 only two hydrogen atoms. Then out of the two hydrogen atoms, one hydrogen atom can bond formation takes place with this sp hybridization. With this sp, then sp and s. And here one more bond formation with this sp and s. So two out of in CH2 C2H2, two hydrogens are shared, then each hydrogen can share with each carbon atom. Okay, one carbon atom is takes one hydrogen atom, this carbon atom is takes place one more hydrogen atom, right? What's about remaining bonding, sir? Then we knows that then here in between PZ and PZ, PZ and PZ, one bond formation can be takes place partially, and between PY and PY, one bond formation can takes place, and next bond formation, then one carbon atom can able to form four bonds, no, then one is with the hydrogen atom, then one is with between PZ PZ, next one is between PY PY partially, then next between SP and SP, okay, between SP and SP also the bond formation can be takes place like this, okay, SP and SP bond formation is takes place is this is way. So right here how many bonds are formed, sir? Right, how many bonds? Then 1 1 2 3 4, how many? 5, total 5 bonds, right? Then out of that 5 bonds, this is end on end, then sigma bond, this is also end on end, sigma bond between SP and SP, and here SP and S, okay, so 3 sigma bonds, out of this 5, 3 sigma bonds, and this is also pi bond, why? Because partially, that means 2 pi bonds. Here is this is a way we can draw the molecular structure, okay, the molecular drawing of molecular structure is also an important concept, right? Good data. In case of sp2 hybridization, in case of CH4 only single bond, right? In case of C2H4 one double bond, okay, and in case of C2H2 one triple bond. With this we came to know that the carbon atom can able to form triple bonds and double bond and single bonds also, and the carbon atom can able to then give sp3 hybridization, sp2 hybridization, or sp hybridization also. This is a way to this is the way Linus Pauling is explained the hybridization, okay. In our next class we are going to discuss allotropes of carbon, okay. Thank you.